Hi, it's me again with CorelDRAW Tips and Tricks, and this is part two of this. If you didn't watch part one, we made, or attempted to make this, and I think we did pretty good. Now I'm going to make the interior part of this that you can just see it's just not very good. And I probably made my rectangle a little bit too thick, so we're going to go 0.02. And I need to unlock the ratio and make it like 2 inches tall. That's probably a little bit too thick, but we move it now to the, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hit the plus key on the keyboard. I'm gonna make a copy of that. Well, why isn't it working? My arrow keys aren't working. So whenever you do that, to back up a little bit till you see your other line move, because you don't wanna make too many copies. Oh, I know what I did. I had my nudge factor set on. Let's make it 4 inches. Remember, I changed my nudge factor, so let's make a duplicate and move that down. See, we still got an, let's make sure we don't have two, so we only have one, so we'll move it right back. Maybe the easiest thing to do with this, and I'm gonna nudge that over, would be to take a smart fill and fill in that center and nudge it over, and left click, right click, put this line in there, pretty close to the edge. You wanna make sure it's long enough to, and if I was doing this for real, I'd go back and check the other one. So we've got a line that's only 0.2. So let's change our nudge factor to 0.04 and see what happened. Hit the plus key on the keyboard and move it over. I think that's gonna work, because we're double. So Control D again, move it over. Now to make this work, I've got to select all this. I'm gonna hold down the Alt key and swipe through there, and it selects all those. Control G to group them. And now I'm gonna either do front minus back or back minus front, so it's not that one. So it's gonna be this one, and we got that done. Now, I think they're actually black lines. This circle is 0.044. Let's make another ellipse, 1.05. We'll see what that does. Whoop, I didn't, I'm gonna back up and lock my ratio, 1.05. And then I'm gonna set that on top of this. Hopefully, let's zoom in. I don't want it touching the edges anywhere. So let's make it a little bit bigger. Holding down the shift key. And then I'm going to CE, kind of align them both. I'm gonna make it quite a bit smaller because I don't want this too big. Whoop, I must have grabbed them both. Grab just the ellipse, and you can see ellipse on layer one. Start moving it, or hold down the shift. And I just want it past that edge. I don't know that we are. Let's make it a little bit bigger than, like I said before. So let's make it 90.5. And now let's take the smart fill tool and see if it'll fill that in for us. And we could also fill in the lines, but I'm gonna try to, wow, that worked perfectly. So now let's nudge that smart fill out of the way. Whoop. Change your nudge factor back to 4. I know for a lot of you, this is gonna be a little bit confusing, and it is. This is a pretty hard logo. So nudge it over, and we got this. That looks pretty good. Now we need to group this together, Control G. Now we need to figure out how to get it inside there. And I can't remember. Well, this is the one I'm using, so this is the one I'm gonna use. I need to take everything out of that inside of the circle that's gonna move. Still got my nudge set factor set on 4. I'm gonna move the B down and all the parts of the B. Hopefully, see what that looks like. Nope, that's not gonna work. Tell you what, I'm gonna move the entire logo down. See, it trays pretty good, but it's in different pieces. in different facets. Hopefully it'll stay together enough to, that'll work. Now that, I don't think is gonna work because it's got part of the G or part of the B. And there's also some, maybe some dots in there that you could redraw. Now this tattoo, for some reason, traced really good. The word tattoo, the text tattoo. Let me zoom in a little bit. Let's see what that is. Maybe that'll go. Now that I've got all that, there's some grays in there. I'm going to select everything and I'm going to make it black. Now, here's what we need to do. I think, one, we need to nudge this down, see what it looks like, see what we're missing. We're missing the ring. So what we can do is let's left click, right click, and let's move. See, these are part of our circles. Let's take a 2-point line and go from like right there all the way over to right here. I don't like that line. And let's fill this in with a smart fill tool. Look at that. Now we got that part of the logo. This has that part around it, which we're gonna need. That has that part around it we're gonna need. I really, really need that part of the B to be there. You know what we can try? Let's try this. This B is probably in different parts. Let's nudge it up. So now this is all, wouldn't you know it, I nudged it up to one of the other parts of the drawing. So we got the B. Let's zoom in here. And let's go to object and combine it. That worked. Now, let's take the, let's grab it and go up to effects, contour. Let's contour the outside, oh, like 0.1. Might be way too big. Whoop. Yep. Tell you what we can do. Let's left click, right click. Make it look a little easier, 0.01. Wow, that worked pretty good. We need that outer, hopefully that outer one will fill. Take the smart fill tool and try to grab that outer one. Wow, we did it. Now let's, should have made a copy of the B. Tell you what we can do, you can always back up, control, or just hit the plus key on the keyboard. My plus key isn't working. Let's back up here. Let's control D and move that over. Well, you know what? It might be working. It could have been way over there. Now let's take this and weld it. I mean, not weld it. Tell you what, I'm gonna fix this right here. This should be all one part anyway. And it might make it a little bit better looking. Let's smart fill it. Go ahead and nudge it over. And here we go again. I should have gotten rid of that part. Some of you are trying to follow along. You probably think he doesn't know what he's talking about. And I really don't right now. Okay, we're gonna left click. I'm gonna get rid of this finally. So we won't do that again. I'm going to left click. You gotta be select on an item. Left click, right click, and now let's group it together. And now let's weld it that same distance. Let's zoom in here and take the smart fill tool and fill in that outer ring, move it over, take our copy. Remember we made the copy. So let's smart fill that, nudge it twice. I forgot to use that other one. Looks pretty good. Let's see what it looks like in the center. Let's group this together, Control G. Now, all we have left is putting this circle into there. Tell you what, I try to keep my videos not too long, and maybe you can take a break, and if you're trying to follow along, and we'll go into part three and get this thing finished and put that circle behind that B. I hope that helped. Thank you for watching.